Yeah, hello. As Renato said, my name is Kai. I'm one of the maintainers of the LDC decompiler. And yeah, today I'm talking about the profile guided optimization, which was recently added to the compiler. Okay, there's a lot of specific words in there. Let's explain what it all is. So what is profile guided optimization? It's a recently added to LLVM. It's based on a simple idea. I can have better optimizations if I have more informations. And what is the source for more informations I can use for optimization? Well, I can do a lot of static analysis. And yeah, there's a theory about it. That's a lot of stuff. It's hard work. And you always can't determine everything just from looking at the source. So another way to get information for optimization is to just look at the running application and get information from the application itself. And to do this, there are two approaches. One approach is I can sample the application. I just stop the application in certain amounts of time, look where is the application, and store this data. That's one way to do it, but that's not, I'm going not to cover this in this talk. I'm just covering instrumentation of the source. So that's with LLVM, this is a common approach. We have, for example, the sanitizers, which also add some instrumentation and do a certain stuff. So for optimization, what information do I want to know? For example, I want to know how often is a function called, or if I have a branch, and if how often is the positive, or how often is the branch taken, or how often is it not taken? I simply can count this. Or for example, I can count how often calls the function A the function B to know the dependency for this. So I have to add a lot of counters to the source and collect all this data. I run my application, I collect this data, I dump this to the hard disk, and then I have something which we call a profile of the application. Yes, this is also the main drawback. We run the application to create the information. So the quality of the information we derive depends on the run we do. If we run the application with an average input, I can expect to get some good result. If I run it with an exceptional input, so I look just for specific case, then I get a profile which does not cover everything, and this can also result in, well, not an optimization, but in a performance loss, because I'm pointing the optimizer to the wrong places to optimize. So it's a good way to get information about to use in optimization, but you have to be careful. So the very, very important point with every optimization, by the way, is you have to measure. Just to say this is a proven optimization, I just use it blindly and think everything will be good, this does not work. So be sure to measure your result. Okay, so this first was about what is profile-guided optimization. The next thing is, what is this D language? Everybody heard of D? Okay. So by the way, there's David, the other maintainer of the LDC, so we have very competent support for it.
He's okay.
Okay. Yes. So what is D for the people who did not heard about it? D was created as a system programming language. It was about 99 or 2000 when it appeared the first time, and it was really meant to be what the name implies, a better C++, but today we are proud of having our own language. But yeah, we are using C-like syntax, so you can immediately read it if you are known to C or C++. We also use static typing. That's also the same like C++. What's better, we have a good module support. So this will come in C++. I think in the next standard or so, we already had it and it's very good. And one of the good points of the language is we support many paradigms. So we have polymorphism. You can do some object-oriented programming. We also support the functional style if you prefer that. We have generics and a lot of other style, and it's all well integrated. So you don't have to switch to this style or this style. You can mix it up and it works all good together. Yeah, from templates are also known from C++, but with D it is going to be a step further. We have really template metaprogramming with a nice added if, so then you can choose which template is selected based on some conditions. Let's make it very easy to use template metaprogramming, and it's not the hard stuff in C++. That's very nice. Yeah, we use a garbage collector. This is always a point of discussion. Is this good or is this not good? The language uses this, but there's also work on it to replace it with, or to make it, let's say, a plug-in, and to use memory management by hand, for example. It has some drawbacks, maybe, but let's see, a garbage collector is always a safety guard. You don't have certain memory problems with it. And also nice, a unique feature, I think, it's called compile time function execution. You can say that certain functions are executed by the compiler, not at runtime, but at compile time, so that you don't have to run it at runtime, just insert the result into the binary and that's it. That can make things very fast. For example, if you have regular expressions, and you know the expressions at compile time, then you can compile this regular expression into D code, and this gets all the optimization done by LLVM, and that's very, very fast. So there are certain use cases for it, and that makes it very nice. Yes, LDC is one of the decompilers available, and it's a let's say a combined effort. We have a reference compiler, it's the DMD compiler, and the first D comes from the fact that the front end is now written in D itself, and LDC uses this front end and adds some C++ glue code to it to generate the LLVM ER, and then uses the LLVM backends. So we support a lot of the backends LLVM support, but we are just copying the reference front end. So we say we are really compatible with our compiler, but we generate really industrial style machine code. That's very good. Yeah, if someone is more interested about the compiler, I think in 2014 I had at this place a talk about the inner working of LDC, so you can download the slides on the FOSDEM page if you want to know more about it. Okay, so we have now the part profile guided optimization, which is provided by LLVM. We have the LDC compiler, and now we needed to plug this all together. And yes, with the latest release, it's already there. So if you go to our GitHub page and download the binaries for Linux, you get it for free. But of course, the implementation was not for free. And one guy, Johan, made the effort to really implement this. And it was, let's say, a lot of work. What was needed to be done? The first, we have to add the source code instrumentation. which boils down to we have to insert calls to LLVM intrinsic at the right places. And if you look at the pull request, then you see a typical pattern to it. We have a PGO, Profile Guided Optimization class, that's more or less copied from the same class from Clang. And this class tracks the state of the current function. And so what you always see is I have to get a reference to this tracker class. I inform this class about the current statement where I'm currently in, and at the right place, you have to do something with the counters. For example, okay, I'm entering the function, I have to increment the counter corresponding to this function. This is a common pattern. There are also code to count how is the branch taken or not taken, and this must all be added. So we have a big visitor, more or less, which goes through the abstract syntax tree, and this needs to do all this stuff. This was really added, and that's a lot of work because D is a full-featured language, not a toy language. So parts of the compiler, the front end, I said, is written in D, so that's really a lot of work to do. And there's no automatic way to add it. Yeah, another point is now that we have the instrumentation, we also need to add the profiling paths to the path manager. And one of the things we do with LDC is that we support different versions of the LLVM backend. And this leads always to some kind of ugly code because the instruction profiling path is a bit new. It was added in LLVM 3.7, I think. And with LLVM 3.9, the name was changed. It was renamed. So just after a year, we had to introduce this if to say, okay, if you are using a newer version of LLVM, then stick to this legacy name, and otherwise, use the old name. So that's also a common pattern in the glue code of LDC. We always have to check for the version of LLVM and then use this name or that name or different order of parameters also. That's sometimes a bit annoying to support. Okay, what else needed to be added? We have the profile data. So we collect all these counters, the counter data, and the counter data is attached to the function or some basic blocks, for example, for loops or ifs. And this must be after the end of the program written to disk. And this required a bit of fiddling how to identify where I am in the source code and put it to disk. So you have to add some function for reading and writing this profile data. And when I'm say reading, this also means we have them, the data, and we must bring it to LLVM. And if this is done via the metadata of LLVM, so reading also implies that we go through the data and attach it again to the LLVM IR. So it's a bit of work to do this. Yeah, and not everything is just lowered to machine instructions by LLVM. There's also small runtime library. And a small runtime library we have to link to. So at first, our driver needs to know if we switch on profile guided optimizations, we have to link to an additional library. That's one part, that's easy. The other part is we need the library. So we take the easy approach and edit the profile RT library to our repository. And we did this for each supported LLVM version. So this is a big directory which contains the profile RT from I think 3.7 to 5 LLVM 5 now. So because that's the easiest way to do it. Otherwise, we would have another external dependency, which would be annoying. Okay, but that's the whole stuff. And with this done, we are ready to use profile-guided optimization with our LDC compiler. Okay, I said the latest release contains it, at least for Linux, because this is, as far as I know, not available for Windows, for example. But with Linux, you can go to our GitHub page, download the compiler, and everything works as described here. So what you do? You have a test program or whatever application you have. I called it the pgotest.d. And the first is we have to add the instrumentation during the compile process. So you use this Langley switch profile instro generate. I think it's the same name used by Clang. And this just not only compiles the module, but also adds the instrumentation. One good hint here is just give it a different name so you know you're having this binary with the instrumentation. The reason is simple. Adding all these counters, it's a lot of stuff, and if you're out of luck, you're having a counter for every basic block, and this is also a great performance impact. You do not want to distribute this this instrumented version to any user. So just use a different name and everything is right. Okay, so you now have the instrumented binary. Just run it. When you run it, it will write the profile data at the end to the hard disk. And yeah, two things here. The default name is default.profraw. And you can change this name. And you want to do this because of two reasons. Maybe default is a very generic name. And if you do it a lot, you get this file will always overwritten. And the second thing is you will do many runs of it. And for every run, you like to collect the data and just merge it into one profile. So you really need several of these profile files. And for this, you can either give it here a name after with the equal sign and then the name, or you can use an environment variable. And in this name, you can also use some parameters which can be replaced, for example, with the process ID. So you can really say, I have here a script file and I run my test application with 10 different inputs, then you can get 10 different profile data files. And what you do, if you have these profile data files, you need to convert it. Therefore, we have the LDC prof data tool. There's no magic in it. It's just a renamed LLVM prof data, but it's renamed because we are tied to a specific LLVM version. And again, there can be many LLVM versions installed on a, for example, in Linux. And with this, we make sure that we are using the right one for our tool. And this tool has just two basic options, merge and show. For the run, you use the merge option, and the merge option, there you give all the prof raw files you have generated, and it creates the final profile data file. And with the output parameter, just give it a name. There's some format conversion in it, but basically it merges all the profiles together and create a format which is again readable by the compiler. Yeah, and then you're done. You can take the second compile one. In this case, you see use command switch. You get the profile data with it, and then LLVM hopefully gives you a better optimized version of your program. Okay, and again, the hint, measure the result, because that's only runtime, that's really looking at the runtime behavior of the application, and it can go wrong. It might not, but it can go wrong, so measure the result. Okay, what kind of optimization is done with this? With LLVM 3.9, there's a new optimization introduced, which uses exclusively the information derived from a profile-guided optimization, and this is called the indirect call promotion. And that's I think it's a very important optimization, because indirect calls, so I'm calling a function through a function pointer, that's very often used in, for example, object-oriented languages, but also, for example, in C, it's common to have a pointer to some function and do the call about this pointer. So the optimization we can do here is, when we know which function is called through the pointer, then I don't use the pointer, I call the function directly. And yeah, okay, that's a pointer. The pointer can point to many functions, so we want to know what is the, let's say, the most likely called function, or the most likely two called functions. Yeah, and how do we get this information? We simply count how often is this function called and from where is it called, and that's exactly the information we can collect with the profile guided optimization in our profile data. So this is a nice optimization, and the benefit of this is, if we know what is the most likely called function and replace it with a direct call, then we enable other LLVM optimizations, for example, function inlining, which can say that for the most common function, it's a very, very fast path because we have eliminated all the branches in it. Yeah, let's look first at the high level and then at the low level. So this is decode, and I think it should be readable for everyone. Okay, I have a simple function which is really simple. It just returns one value, and there's also a function pointer to it. And to make the things more interesting, we're going to have a loop and call this function in a loop. So there's no sense behind it from this function is doing really something useful. It only demonstrates we're calling the function indirectly through a pointer. Okay, and what does the indirect function call promotion do? It's quite simple. It checks if the pointer is the most likely called function. Okay, we have only one function, so that's quite easy. And if it's the case, then we call this function directly. And for sure, this is only a heuristical method, so the compiler does not know what happened with the variable, maybe in other places. So we also have the fallback and say, okay, if it's not this function, then just do the call by the function pointer. So this is a very simple approach, and for sure you can do it yourself. You don't need compiler support for it. That's with other optimizations, that is not that easy, but if you have a good knowledge about which function gets called, then you can do it yourself. And yeah, you can really do it in D with a neat syntax. So we can define a template which hides the check for the most likely function and then call the likely function or use the function pointer. And then we have this nice syntax, which is a very special feature of the language, but it's readable for, I think, because we say we have the function pointer and we apply this isLikely template, and this template has the most likely function as a parameter, and everything else is hidden under the template. So we could do all this stuff by ourselves, and we don't need the compiler support. So that if you know it, you can do it this way. But that's not really a very good approach, because you have the problem you don't know which is the, or in most cases you don't know which is the most likely called function. Look at LLVM, it has millions of lines of code, and at a specific place, what is the most likely called functions? Don't know. So let's do the compiler the work. Okay, let's go down to the ER level. So just how is the indirect call represented at the ER level? It's quite simple. We load the value of the pointer. So we have here this pointer, and load it into the virtual register 1. And then we just call the function. That's very simple, load value and jump. Okay. Okay. So what is the next? We have the instrumented version. The instrumented version is the step, is the immediate step. We have to add the counter for the function, for the loop. We are in a loop. If you remember, I had a loop. And we need to count how often is the loop used at this point. We also need to record which target we do call with this pointer. And of course, the loading and calling the function is also present. But there's a lot of stuff around it. When we run the instrumented application, it generates the profile data. You can also use the show argument to the LDC prof data tool and look at the generated profile. And for example, you see this ICP function. It has one counter instrumented in it, and it's called 1,000 times. That's what I would expect from my source. And there's also the main function. There are two counters in it, one for the function and one for the loop body. And the function is called one time. So there you can get an overview of your profile. Yeah, and now we use the profile data to optimize the function. And this is with the O3 switch. We really optimize. And in this case, well, you see we load the pointer. We have a compare with the most likely function, the ICT function, and then a branch. And the branch is, if it's not equal, we go to the original indirect call. That is the fallback. And in the other case, well, we jump over it. And this function was very simple. So the result was inlined by LLVM. And so in the phi instruction, we see, okay, if you come from the forebody, then use the value 42. So in the most likely case, there's no jump at all. And that's what we're going to have. Yeah, and also you see this profile data is attached in the metadata by LLVM. Yeah, what's the result of all this? Johan, who did the pull request for it, he tested it also. And if you only look at the D part of LDC, then the compiler becomes faster by about 7%. This was done on a use case, a test case from an industrial project. And so it's not such some simplistic benchmark, but it's a real test case from application. So that's a very good approach, a result in my eyes. And he had also some more ideas, and these more ideas are therefore is only a sample implementation. He called it the virtual call promotion, which is the same as the indirect call promotion, but applies to classes, which uses a foul table structure to do the virtual call. And with this, there's also ways with the same, with a similar approach to replace these virtual calls with direct calls. And that's a very interesting approach, but not yet committed. Yeah, and so my summary is, it's really worth to have these profile-guided optimizations in our toolbox now, because if you've done it right, you can get a better speed margin. And I think just having 7% faster application with only running the application several times, that's a very good result, I think. Okay, so I'm done now. Are there any questions? Yes.
I might have missed it, but did you mention how much overhead implementation adds? Is it feasible that the implementation runs in production with implementation?
So I did not really mention it. The question was how much overhead there is, and the overhead is really noticeable. You don't want to distribute an instrumented binary, I think it was about a factor or two or so. It's really slow, so you do not want to really distribute this. Yeah, more questions? Excuse me, could you repeat? The question was why we choose this approach with the source code instrumentation. That's that's the generic way to do it. It's work with all backends, so we simply added one and we have it there.
Basically, we had it around, and we might actually, if it turns out to be terrible, we might just ditch it and go to the other one.
Okay, thanks. Yeah.
Thanks for the talk, very interesting. And I was wondering whether you could profile the memory accesses or memory allocations, and then tune the GC triggers, the garbage collection triggering, to you see what I mean?
Yes.
So far, the idea is pretty cool because you can optimize all of this function code and stuff like that. Can you also play, or do you think about playing with the garbage collector?
Okay, so the question is if the instrumentation could also be used for other kind of stuff, for example, memory allocations. And at this point, no. So it's only for, there's also only this. Optimization for the indirect call promotion, but for sure that's the profile guided optimization. It's an area of active development in LLVM, so yes, it should be possible, and but there's no work for it yet, but yes, it should work.
Is there a way to my understanding is that it works very well if the actual function can be inlined at the end. If it can't, if it has to be called eventually, then you're not much better than what the ECU would do anyways.
Yeah, it's so the question is if the function is not inlined, then there's no big benefit with using this optimization. And yeah, it really depends, and it depends on the way the CPU works, because it has a lot to do with the branch prediction in the CPU. So if you're doing an indirect call, and the CPU cannot predict the right target, then there might be a lot of stuff the CPU has to do internally. So it, yeah, it really depends on your target, if it's profitable, if this is a good optimization or if it has no benefit. So no general answer in this case. We really have to measure it.
My follow-up would be, is there a way to remove the optimization or the check at the beginning if you see, okay, inlining doesn't make sense?
Yeah, that's a kind of problem here, because we use data which is collected from runtime. And from there, you don't have the absolute knowledge about all the possible inputs and all the possible branches which can be used. You would do to have some kind of, let's say, global program analysis to really deduce, to say that's the only target for this pointer. And that's not possible now.
So if you had an LTO, if you run this, imagine that the setting, the pointer, is not a global setting. So, I mean, the LTO doesn't know without PGO what the target is. But with PGO, it says this is the most likely. Then you would hoist the whole thing out of the loop and say return 42,000. Right? If the pointer is this, return 42,000. Otherwise, go through the loop. And that will be a big saving.
Yeah. So LTO is also supported with LDC. So this could this can be combined. Okay, more questions? Yeah. If not, then thank you very much.